Good evening. For 3 years, their courage and grace has inspired the nation. Today, the families of the four children killed in a crash at Oatlands shared their powerful message of forgiveness at a new festival honouring their lost loved ones.
On Marbel Cassis's 13th birthday, her life changed forever. She was walking to get ice cream at Oatlands when a drunk driver struck and killed her four cousins. Marbel survived.
In the blink of an eye, a beautiful moment turned into the worst moment of my life. I will never forget being there and feeling helpless. As much as I tried to help, I couldn't help. I couldn't bring back my best friends.
But 3 years since the tragedy, she's now found peace.
Forgiveness helped me feel free because I didn't have hatred to carry me down.
That powerful act of grace by the Abdallah, Saker and Cassis families has now turned into something far bigger. The first i4Give festival held at Prince Alfred Square in Parramatta today, a day of fun for a community who shared in the grief.
What the Abdallah, Saker and Cassis family received was the true Aussie spirit of helping a mate.
Today also a day to reflect.
I've seen people in our society attack each other, attack institutions, attack people's personal faith. Why do we subject each other to such attacks?
Political differences put to one side, Prime Minister Anthony Albanese nursing Premier Perrottet's baby before both shared how the families have inspired them.
Instead of raging at the injustice of their loss, they found the strength, the courage, and above all, the humanity to choose a path of grace.
I can't commend them enough for the profound lesson in leadership and in grace that they have gifted all of us.
Marbel's birthday was marred by tragedy, but today a celebration for her 16th. What was a day of pain, now a day of hope. Elizabeth Bryan, Nine News.